What's up, my fellow Wastelanders? I'm Dark Populous. Today, I'm going to be showcasing the immersive minigames mod by Pinto Cat for Fallout New Vegas. In the vanilla game, the lockpicking and terminal hacking sequences quickly lose their challenge, and late into the game would just become a chore. Especially the terminal hacking, since it can be easily be abused by backing out of the sequence in order to reset all of your tries so you don't get locked out. Well, the immersive minigame mod adds in a new system that favors a real-time character skill based alternative. So instead of going through the tedious time freezing sequences that we just mentioned, you are now faced with a percentage-based chance to succeed with your lockpicking or your hacking in real time. The chance to succeed or fail with either of the aforementioned events is affected by your character's stats and skills. For example, the higher your lockpicking skill is, the higher chance you have to succeed with a lockpick. And the higher science skill you have, the higher chance you have to successfully hack a terminal. Your luck stat also plays a big role in both hacking and lockpicking, affecting the percentages. Not only does immersive minigames introduce a new way to lockpick and hack, but it also makes breaking the lock or getting locked out of the terminal a percentage-based chance as well. You see, in the vanilla game, you would never really break a lock, since that was only really possible if you forced it. And why would you ever want to do that, unless it was 100% guaranteed that it would work? And as for being locked out of a terminal, the only way that was possible is if you lost all of your tries, and that would only really happen if you didn't ever back out of a terminal and abuse the system where you could reset your tries. But I don't really know anyone doing this, and the only way that you could possibly even make that possible is if you deliberately do it. So the mod making it a percentage-based chance instead makes it more likely to happen, or just possible to happen in general. Not only can you get locked out completely, but there's also a chance your attempts will lead to an increase of the difficulty for the lockpick or terminal. This is unique to the mod and wasn't even in the vanilla game. All of these features are configurable in the mod configuration menu. Don't like the idea of breaking a lock or getting locked out of a terminal? You can disable it. Don't like the chance of a terminal or a lockpick becoming harder if your chances aren't good enough? You can turn that feature off as well. One other big feature of this mod is the ability to allow an attempt to lock or hack any terminal regardless of skill levels. So for example, the lucky revolver inside the Bison Steve Hotel is kept inside a safe with a level 75 lockpick skill requirement. With the immersive minigames mod, you can remove the 75 lockpick requirement and just try your luck at, well, getting lucky, pardon the pun, without the need to have 75 lockpick. In my personal opinion, the 75 lockpick requirement to get the lucky revolver was just silly, since the gun isn't that great at mid to end game anyway. Personally, I believe this is because of its low damage output, its ammo type, and its long reload animation. It's a great gun for early and low level characters, and it isn't really too overpowered. But anyway, back on topic. To initiate a lockpick or hack with this mod, you simply hold down the hotkey, which you can configure in the MCN menu. It's the Z for Zebra key by default. You will know when it's working when you hear... The mod will also have pop-ups appear at the top left of your screen, just like it does in the vanilla game, to indicate when you've successfully lockpicked or hacked a terminal, or if you failed. You can also configure how the heads-up display will display when you lock at an object or anything that can be hacked or picklocked in the MCM menu. Lastly, the mod doesn't remove the vanilla lockpick and hacking sequences. You can still do that as normal until you change your immersive minigames mod hotkey to the same as the activate hotkey, which is E by default in the vanilla game. Only then will it overwrite the vanilla sequences in favor of the mods. It does this seamlessly, with no issues. Overall, this is an amazing mod that fixes one of the most obnoxious gameplay elements in New Vegas, in my personal opinion. I recommend it to anyone and everyone playing New Vegas, since it's more RPG-like and more convenient to use. Anyways, I hope you check this mod out. The link to it will be in the description of this video. Until the next time, guys, I'm Dark Populous. Peace out.